Aujourd'hui, nous allons entretenir nos téléspectateurs de ce que les spécialistes appellent justement
And today we are going to be addressed by an economist who refers to all economic activities that are being carried across the sea, ocean, river, and lake.
En relation avec la mer, les océans, les rivières, ainsi de suite.
And these are all activities that are usually being carried across the ocean. Like, for instance, just to give a few examples, recently Congo Republic was caught up in an economic sabotage when a high-speed fiber cable was delinked in the ocean accidentally by a boat just near Pointe Noire offshore.
Ici au Congo, on va dire que l'activité tournait au ralenti.
Several activities were hampered, including the mobile service that actually ran at severe losses in Congo Brazzaville. They actually went through a hefty price due to lack of internet connection.
L'économie bleue en rapport avec la mer, la rivière, les lacs, etc.
All this is to emphasize the importance of the sea and its contribution towards the economy. And of course, we have 38 countries out of 54 in Africa with sea front lines. Earlier on, we spoke to economic specialists who highlighted the relevancy of blue economy to African countries. His name is Sostin Luala Mabika.
Oui, mais aujourd'hui, avec la charte de Lomé, nous l'appelons maintenant l'économie.
Today, with the Lomé Charter, we can raise the issue concerning blue economy. In my country, Gabon, we are talking about blue Gabon, to develop the economy through everything that we have at the sea. The stakes are important. We know that through the sea, we can reduce unemployment, famine, and poverty. All the major powers have mastered the sea. We stayed long without utilizing this, but now we are aware. We know that 90% of trade is by sea. Everything we need for our economy comes from the sea.
Nous savons très bien que toutes les grandes puissances sont des puissances qui maîtrisent la mer.
That is why we must put in place all amenities required at the sea.
Et c'est maintenant que nous prenons les choses en main pour que nous faisons de notre
And it's now that we are now realizing that we have to utilize the sea to our benefit.
Notre économie dépend de la mer.
Because our economy depends on the sea, because everything comes through the sea to our country.
And
that's why we must treat it well.
C'était les propos d'un expert, doublé d'un stratège aussi.
But John David, I would like to understand, the sea is very important for our own good, but how best can we profit from it?
Ah oui, là, vous posez une question tout à fait pertinente et centrale.
Okay, Lynette, you raise an issue of extreme importance. All that is needed is peaceful sea and control of other factors like piracy in the sea, something that can really sabotage the economy if well not checked.
Un véritable cancer, n'est-ce pas?
When there is insecurity at the sea, the insurance companies increase insurance policies, and at the end of the day, it's consumers like you and me who are paying for these additional costs.
Les polices d'assurance, et c'est nous qui sommes ici, n'est-ce pas, sur le continent, qui payons le surcoût, c'est-à-dire les produits deviennent plus chers, la vie devient plus difficile.
Now, when the insurance cover becomes expensive, also it translates to life, which becomes also expensive too. Now, the Africa, that we have understood that there is a whole architecture in place to ensure that safety will not be what in the Gulf of Guinea and also in Kresma, whose headquarters is here in Pointe Noire, are only linked to this architecture there.
Les Africains ont essayé de mutualiser leurs efforts pour mettre leur système de sécurité en commun.
Now we must enhance security system in the sea to ensure that things run smoothly and it does not translate to the common man who at the end will pay it heavily in terms of insurance cover and also in terms of
pour l'Afrique. Merci de nous avoir écoutés. À la semaine prochaine.